Let's grab ourselves this halberdiery that we're never going to use. And then it's probably time to go and find the nearby Society of Grace. I forget where exactly we're looking for this, but somewhere on the outskirts here. There it is. Up to the old Church of Inhibition, I presume. I've forgotten that we were here, but yeah, what else are we doing here if not to grab ourselves another sacred tear? And then we'll get on with the actual business of today, which will be wrestling with a giant dragon, unfortunately. Hello, Vike. Alright, Sight Grace, good. Sacred tear, good. Now. Yeah, we're about to get wrecked, I think. Nope, we're good. Oh, no we're not. We are in fact bad. Ooh, that running L1. That's damage right there. Very nice. Alright, Sacred Tier 10, good. We haven't got any more golden seeds, nope. We've got 12 flasks, that's a good number. So I guess our next stop is back underground. We'll head to the Moonlight Altar. Now, I've got no reason to be fighting three dragons, I don't think. Three mini dragons, but we definitely are going to have to fight the glintstone dragon that guards the entrance to the cathedral. Well, I mean, we could just run around it, but that's no fun. What we got? Oh yeah, we got all dungies plus 10. Excellent. He'll help us out until the dragon does one breath at the ground and then we're all dead. But we'll cross that bridge when we come to it in a few moments' time. Ran straight past the Sight of Grace like an idiot. That's not a good start. That's really not. But we've got Rocksling. It's saved our butt countless times. Sling those rocks. We've already got him on the ground, that's good. Maybe this won't go so badly. He says. His torrent starts to take a beating. Jeez. Didn't realise he actually had a sword in his mouth at times. Dungeat is still going strong. That's good. Yeah, maybe this fight isn't so bad with Rocksling. Well done, Dungeat. You're alright. And we got some free Thin Beast bones as well. Good stuff. And enough Starlight Shards to buy any more puppets that we might require. So I think we'll spend these runes on some more levels of int. Oh, more Starlight Shards by the look. Lovely. And yeah, that gives us enough to learn Comet, I believe. Now, do we want to keep all these spells on our bar? Probably. But now we've got Comet. Not Comet Azure yet, unfortunately. That requires 60. But still, Comet should be fun. Can be cast repeatedly and whilst in motion, so it's just a better version of our other Comet, perhaps. Charging enhances potency, whereas this one, hold to continue releasing the sorcery power. Okay, so it's just a better version of Glintstone Comet Shard, I guess. And then we've got glintstone ice crag if we just need something small. Cool. Now, where's Bay Ranny hanging out? We should have a word with her whilst we're here. Whee. Maybe we need a bit more light on the situation. Ah. Love ahead. So yeah, so she'd gone off after her fingers, hadn't she? Yeah. A lot of people talking about love. And there we go. That's some dead fingers right there. And there's our girl. What's up, Ranny? You got the job done by the look of it. Looks like you've hacked a massive hole in the middle of your fingers. And yeah. They look pretty dead, all told. I think we'll put a ring on it. Milady.
So it was thee who would become my lord. Perhaps I needn't have warned thee. I am pleased, however. Thou art a fitting choice. I go now to the night sky. It is there I shall find mine order. I bid thee travel the path of the lord, and once all is done, we shall see each other once more.
So yeah, basically the same deal as with Fia and Yuki. She said, go become a lord. And she's left behind the Dark Moon Greatsword as well. Ooh. Very nice. I wasn't sure if she was going to leave behind a rune as well, like Fia did, but that's fine. Causes frost buildup. Requires more strength than we've got, but we could two-hand it. But no, that feels more like a trace thing, with it being a mage blade and all. So we'll probably just mount it on the wall once we have our own cozy home with Ranny up in the stars somewhere. Maybe we'll build a nice little house on the moon. That'd be fun. And then I guess we teleport out of here. So, it's time to become a lord, probably. Whilst we're here, though, whilst we're in Leyndell, there is something else I'd like to grab. Because at some point I'd like to get all the chiefs done during these runs. And one of them involves getting legendary armaments. And I believe there's one legendary armament that you can only get before a certain point in the game, and then it gets locked off. So we should probably go and see about getting that right now before I forget. Because I don't know who's going to get the achieve. Maybe it'll end up being Sami or Noob, just because they haven't got endings planned. But either way, I want to see where this legendary armament is. Because I'm pretty sure it's something to do with that spear. Oh yeah, there we go. I saw a shiny on the spear. Now there's a crucible knight over there. They're always a pain in the butt. Oop, if we fall in the right place? Maybe. Yeah, it looks like we've fallen in the right place. Good. Now we just need to work our way up this. Oh, Jesus. Don't you lot start. I'm so close. Piss off. There we go, bolt ground sacks. Maybe I'll get it on Sami at some point, because yeah, it's a dex weapon, I think. It's a dex spear. Let's have a look. It's got the ancient lightning spear, Ash of War, that's cool. The great ancient dragon Grand Sax once rained calamity on the capital. The only time in historical record that Leyndell's walls are fallen. Ah. So Grand Sax is the one who's responsible for the big holes in the wall, I guess. But yeah, finally got that, so that's nice. Might also be nice to get whatever's on that roof. Stone sword key, very good. And yeah, if we're going to be able to fast travel at any point, we're just going to need to get out of combat, so let's just scuttle away, shall we? That bugger thinks he wants to go. Does he want to come with us, or does he want to fall down a hole? He wants to come with us. That's nice of him. Make the ride just a little bit more entertaining. But yeah, I'm digging some of these weapons. I guess it's just the fact that it's dual curved swords that I'm digging rather than the fact that they're int weapons, but it's nice to be able to just do melee builds with int and melee builds with faith and everything else. Adds a bit of variety to everything. Evening time, which means we might get jumped by a knight's cavalry, but we might not. Ah, maybe all these little boys despawn at night. So if there's a knight's cavalry, you only have to fight that instead of the little lads. Because you won't want to fight them all at once. I'm pretty sure when Noob came through here, he only had the cavalry to worry about, so that's cool. That's something that's useful to know as to whether or not you're going to get ambushed by Horse Boy. Now then, Sam, are we going to do this without tomfoolery this time? Without you just throwing yourself back off the elevator in a way that was totally your fault and definitely not mine. Maybe this is one elevator that we just don't need to reset between runs. Maybe we won't need multiple runs, maybe we'll just one-shot the boss. It's possible. You can't deny that it's possible. Now, what's everyone got to say for themselves? Monster required ahead. Friend required ahead. Visions of blood loss. Well, we're going to fight him in his own game. We are bringing the blood loss in spades. pretty messed up right there. Pretty massive.
Dearest Mikola. You must abide alone a while. Welcome, honored guest, to the birthplace of our dynasty.
Yeah, this guy's pretty cool. Right, there's our crystal drunk. We're now safe from his special attack for a little while. Now what you got for his friend? Ah, the delay on that. Duo. Unus. Yep. Now we're in trouble. Okay, we're not in that much trouble. He's got wings. This is cool. Oh, he's over there. That's cool. Oh, we staggered him. That's always welcome. Ah, jeez, panic rolling. Panic flasking as well. No, he's over there, somewhere. Jeez. Panicking, big time. Another safety flask. He's almost dead. We got him. First try. Mohggers. The Blood Lord is bested. Now, does Mikaela have anything to say about that? Probably not. They don't seem to be in the best of shape. How many runes did we get? 420,000 or so. Jeez. I mean, we haven't even got the gold scarab on. And I would have had time to switch to it as well if I'd thought about it. Jeez. Wow. I don't know what to do. More vigor's always nice. More arcane would be nice. Wow. Sweet. That's a juvenile message, my friend. But it made me snigger slightly, so you can have an updo. Now, is there anything else to do around here? We could sneak up behind Mikaela. We got a platform over here. Well done. Yeah. We did it. Sami and Sami. With our blood-soaked twin blades. I feel like we're not supposed to throw ourselves off the edge of that cliff. But yeah, I guess that's... Oh yeah, that's the big bridge that you cross over after you kill the mimic tier, I think. Probably. Well, yeah, I guess we get on with our lives. We killed Moog. Guess we'll just teleport somewhere else. The cocoon of the Imperium. So yeah, Melania and Mikella are Imperians. So that is definitely Mikella lurking in there. What's he doing in there? Who can say? Got a little ring shining there on his finger. But yeah, guess we'll go about our business then. We got the First Church of America unlocked, so we could pop over there. Did we kill Borealis at any point? No, where's that last sacred tear that I'm missing? It's not here. Oh no, it's up the hill. Yeah, I remember now. Oh, and there's that body up there that's got 3 Smithing Stone 7s on it. They might be handy if we want to get ourselves a second maxed out weapon, which we probably do. Well, I'm not seeing any sign of Borealis, so... Oh, hello. It's getting foggy. Have I spoken too soon? Oh, crawdads. Didn't you? I feel like that means Borealis isn't around, because I didn't see those crawdads during the Borealis fight at any stage. And you know you would have seen them, and they would have tried to fire their piss jets at us. So yeah, I feel like he's been deaded. And now I've got no idea of where we are. Thanks to the old snowstorm. Have we had a proper look in this camp at any point? Is there anything to this camp, or is it just some barricades? It's just some barricades. That's fine. So I guess we'll make our way over to the map marker. Although given how easily we dealt with Mo, maybe it's time to pop back to Castle Sol and finally deal with the commander up there. Because someone will have to do it at some point. May as well be God-killer Sami. Well, demi-God-killer. We haven't killed any actual gods yet. Maybe we'll pop back to base as well. See if we've got enough smithing stones to level up our peeler at all. Yeah, we've got 4, so we just need 6 more, and then we can move on to the 8s. That's nice. Oh, we've got a Clawmark Seal still equipped for some reason. Oh, I suppose we should switch up our Flask of Wondrous Physic as well before I inevitably forget for like 20 episodes. I mean, Twiggy's just nice to have in it. I quite like Twiggy. Lets me be a bit riskier. Speaking of risky. Get in there and have a rumble, shall we? He actually managed to knock us over with that breath attack. That's lame. Synchronized wailings as we get wrecked. Can't believe I didn't think of summoning before when I fought these lads. Well done, Uncle Sami. Now, where's the other one? Yep, breathing on the wrong target there, my friend. Lovely stuff. That's so much easier than fanning around, trying to cheese them in the doorway. And it's like, why was I even cheesing them in the doorway when there is a sight of grace right here? It's the perfect fight to just take risks. I was being a foolish fool. We'll go and lock the old side routes, I think. It's all kind of optional, this bit, but we'll do it anyway. Sami's feeling pretty invincible right now after that wrecking of Moog. Oh, but she's also feeling pretty clever, which is why she's going to bust out the old bow. Yeah, that's a clever girl. Now, oh, yep, this one comes for us, that's fine. Surprises me how precise you can be with your shots in Elden Ring. They do pretty much go where you want them to go, which they never did in the Souls games. This is what enables you to cheese the commander in this castle. Because I've had a peek and I know how it's done now. We're not going to do it on Sam, I don't think. We're going to try and beat him legit at least once before we start cheesing him. Now, where's the next lad? Are you too far away? Nope. Nearly got him. Now he's going to try and shoot back, and he's just going to end up shooting into his own crossbow, or ballista if you will. Can we shoot him under the ballista? Yeah, in the crotch. Take that. I find it curious that they drop exile hoods even though they are spirits. They shouldn't really be dropping any of their armour, I feel. But we'll take it. Free armour is free armour. And that's that little side path cleared out. Lovely. Although, what happens if we drop off the side from the top here? Because there was a little walkway. Yeah, there's a little walkway there that doesn't seem to serve much purpose. But then there's also down there. Get some freezing grease. Cool. Now what does this do for us? Dogs? Oh, bird. Yep. Hate the birds. Now, are you going to come over and play doggo? Or are you just going to die? Ah, and there's the doorway that we opened. So yeah, dropping off that side bit doesn't really do a lot for you. That's good to know.